Working with the Sokol Builder is great, but actually the Sokol language in the query language in Salesforce has so many other options and features that actually are not supported by the Sokol Builder. Many of the cases you will not need these, but if there are cases where you want to do some summations, group bys, averages, counts, any of these things, well, maybe that's a good time actually to drop the Sokol Builder and just use the full power of Salesforce Sokols, okay, and create them yourself. What's the point of this demo? You see this overview, which is great, but you see that actually it now shows some products double. Well, that's not very nice. What we actually want is every product separately, and we want to have the sum of these quantities shown here. Okay, so we want to group by all of these product names, and we actually want the quantity to summarize. Cool. How to do that? Let's go back to our data sources and let's create a new one. It's going to be a Sokol data source. Data source demo. Sokol power. Okay. It's going to be a list of objects in this case. Let's save it. Okay, let's not use a Sokol Builder. If you have started with a data source and you have created it with a Sokol Builder and now you want to do cool stuff with it that the Sokol Builder cannot do, like very complex where clauses, things like that, then it's actually very easy to switch that. You just have to uncheck this this checkbox, make sure it's not checked. If it's checked, it assumes that it's all created by the Sokol Builder. If it's unchecked, then of course you can do all your cool stuff and it will take all of the information from your query. Okay, so this we can delete. We don't need it anymore. I've quickly prepared a query to use here and I'll just guide you through it. So in this query, I want to do a group by on the product ID, and I want to select from the opportunity line items, which are the opportunity products. I take the opportunity ID, I filter on the opportunity ID, I'll take the name, use the max function there, and take the sum of the quantity. Very important to notice is that I've used an alias for every field that I put here. So every field that I use a function on, like sum, count, max, min, all of these fields, well, they need an alias. No alias, it's unusable in PDF Butler. I'm very sorry. Okay, so if you want to do some more complex things here, like doing an AND with an 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 2 equals something here, and then or another thing, fields underscore underscore C equals empty again, something like that. Perfectly possible. You can choose full power of the query for you. The only thing we do not support is that you write subqueries inside your select. Using subqueries in your where class, perfectly possible, no issue. Subqueries in your select, not possible. We have done that. We do not support it for a very good reason, because we have our nested data sources. Our nested data sources have much more power than actually the subqueries from Salesforce. They are more performant and they are much smarter, because you don't need these master-child relationships for our nested data sources. Okay, so let's use this one, save it. And now let's go to, we have a new data source. Let's cool. Let's go to our configuration. First, add the data source to me. So, Sokol power. Okay, this field was quantity. For some reason, it's not there. But if it's not there, you can just add it. And the quantity, of course, is a number field. Okay. So we have now our data source perfectly there. Let's take a look in our documents. What is our use case? We want to create a new table with the grouped products. So no duplicated products anymore. That's what we're going to do. So everybody knows already, we're going to create a table row to repeat that entire row. It was on Sockle Power. Okay, that's our row that's now defined. And when we go to that row, we add some childs to fill in the actual fields, the actual information. So that's the name. Okay, that's that. And now we add a second field for the quantity. And that must be the sum of the quantity here. So we go take the quantity here, no formatting, and again the quantity. Save to server. Okay, no errors. Let's take a look. See if this list is now improved. Create a document again. Single click. Oh, it's already there. Damn, it's also so fast. Okay, so let's take a look at our document. And indeed, what we see is no duplicates. And our quantities, yeah, they are just calculated, summarized as I expected. So instead of having duplicate rims and duplicate tires, we just have now a single grouped overview, no duplicates anymore, and the quantities are nicely summed. So that's taking full control over your Sockles. And if you have the power, please do so. Otherwise, use the Sockle Builder. I actually use the Sockle Builder every day, and I'm a very technical person. The Sockle Builder is great if you just want to select a bunch of fields and follow relationships. If you want to write the Sockles yourself, please be careful, because the Sockle is case sensitive. So if you mistype an uppercase or a lowercase in your API name, then it might not work, or the field might not not show correctly. So everything is case sensitive, and Salesforce behind the scenes will run your query and will just make sure the API names are correct. And we don't know the API names, so we can't interpret it and mix and match it everything perfectly. So please be aware that the API names have to be case sensitive. So that's our demo. Thank you.